There was a time when you would have been called a witch.
Yes.
In fact, you would have been burned at the stake, but not anymore.
If you do, could I have this jacket?
I'm Chani Nicholas, and this is Star Power. Today, my guests are Jane Fonda and Lily Tomlin, and we're going to see what their charts have to say. This is you as a birth chart. This is the sky, the moment you took your first breath. It's a snapshot of the sky. I like to start with the ascendant, and yours is in Cancer. And Cancer is a very emotional sign. It's very sensitive. It's very caring. And it might even get like teared up when it hears about.
Tears up a lot.
We were just talking about something and of course I teared up.
And right on the other side of your ascendant is the goddess of laughter.
No kidding.
Really?
Yeah, the goddess.
Well, this is too stunning.
The goddess is Ephrosyne. And she was the...
Ephrosyne?
Yes.
Like Ernestine almost.
Yes, exactly. And then the planet that rules that, so the planet that steers the direction of your life is the moon, because you're Cancer rising. And we find your moon up in the 10th house of career. That planet is in Aries, which is feisty and fiery. Mm. And it's a fighter. Mm. And it goes first. So on your career point, you have the asteroid Hermes. And Hermes is the communicator, but also the trickster, the shapeshifter.
Oh, this is choice.
She's got so many people living in her.
Right, right. Yeah. And so this kind of shape-shifting energy that you're able to communicate through all of these different personas. And then your sun in Virgo, which is, Virgo's very internal, and it's always trying to figure out what's wrong, what doesn't fit, what isn't working, how to get it right.
Oh boy, that's true.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, yes. Gotta do it again. Let's do that again.
Yeah.
Just to do some little thing.
And interestingly, on your marriage point, you have the asteroid Wagner.
Really?
Yeah.
That's her 48-year partner, is Jane Wagner. What does that mean, asteroid?
The thousands and thousands and thousands of asteroids, and they're just named kind of randomly. It's just this rock that someone named Wagner that just happens to be on her marriage.
That is amazing.
That is so
You've
far out.
You've got to tell Jane that.
That she's just an old rock?
No, that she's an asteroid.
It's so amazing. It's just astounding.
Yeah. And you were born just after a full moon, so that means that you're here to fully live out your life's purpose to shine, to also connect with a great many people. There's a big fullness to your moon.
So nice, thank you.
Aww.
Well, I can't wait to hear this.
Yeah? You ready?
I wake up ready.
Jane, this is your chart.
Mm-hmm.
We see a lot of Sagittarius, a lot of fire, because you have Sun in Sagittarius and Venus in Sagittarius and a couple other things. There's this need to take action, a need to move, a need to be on the quest for truth and all of that.
That's me.
My Sagittarius is empty.
I'll fill it in for you.
There you go.
I'll make up for it.
This is pathetic.
You're good, you're good. So both of you have Sun Venus, which is really sweet and lends you a beauty and a charm and likability. You have Sun Venus and Lilith together. She's sexuality, she's raw feminine energy and power. Mm. And the patriarchy doesn't know what to do with her.
Mm-hmm.
So it blames her for things that she's just being herself.
Mm-hmm.
And so there, I don't know if that resonates with you.
Yeah, it does.
Have you ever had that experience?
Uh-huh. I've kind of lived it all my life.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And so there's that great wild power and energy that you carry.
Mm-hmm. So you show me more respect now after hearing this. I mean, take this in, what she's saying.
I'm sitting here feeling so respectful.
Okay, good.
We find you with a Capricorn rising, Capricorn ascendant. So Capricorn is a sign of work and work ethic. There's like, I am gonna get stuff done.
Yeah.
I have a huge mountain to climb and I will get there.
That's me.
So then you've also got Mercury in your first house, which means that you need to be a relayer of information.
Oh, yeah. Oh, boy. That's
and a speaker.
True.
And you've got Uranus, the planet of upheaval and rebellion and revolution and activism, making a perfect trine to that. So it's like you are a megaphone for the information that's going to shake up the status quo.
Yeah.
And be sometimes delivering a message that's a little turbulent,
yeah,
a little disturbing. So you've got an Aries moon, which is about leading your life in a daily way that's got a lot of energy, needing to take action, needing to try new things, needing to do something that's never been done maybe, or in a way that it's never been done. You have a Leo moon, which means you need to live out your life purpose. They're having a little bit of drama. They're having a little bit of flair. Your moon is also conjunct Pandora. Pandora opens up and all of the woes and the burdens of the world escape, but also when she closes the jar, hope is left inside. And so she opens up humanity to the pain and suffering of being human, but she has the hope as well.
Well, that's a nice thing to think about, yeah.
I think it's true because she's not just, you know, woe is me, and there is a fruitful ending if right. people will listen.
If we address the pain, mm-hmm. if we don't shy away from what the problem here and mm-hmm. the real human suffering. Mm-hmm.
Thank yeah. you.
You're welcome.
Yeah, it's very
it's an
honor.
Really interesting.
It's an honor.
Maybe. I would have been burned too. We would have been burned together.
Together. We would have been there together.
Yeah.
So who's going to get your jacket?